Hi friends, welcome back to Slide Hunt with the video tutorial on C++ programming. In this tutorial, I'm gonna teach you else if statement and nested if statement. Here we write a simple program that checks the marks of a student and then says whether he gets either first division or second division or third division or fail. If his percentage of marks is 60 or more, then we're gonna say he gets first division. If percentage of marks in between 45 to 60, then we say he gets second division. If the marks in between 30 to 45, then we say he gets third division. And if he gets less than 30, then we're gonna say he fails. Okay, next we create an integer type variable, int percent. Next, I'm going to ask user to enter percentage of marks. So I'm going to write here cout, and here I'm going to write enter percentage of marks, and then end line. Next, we need to read the number, so I'm gonna write here cin, and then here we refer percent. The number that the user entered will be stored to the variable percent. The next thing is we need to check the marks. For that, I'm gonna write here if a pair of parentheses and then a pair of curly braces. Inside the parentheses, I'm going to write if percent greater equal to 60. If this condition is true, then if block will be executed. So inside the if block, I'm going to write cout, and here I'm going to write first division, and then end line. In our previous tutorial, we checked only one condition, and for that we used else statement after if. But here we are going to check multiple conditions. For this, we use here else if statement. So I'm going to write here else if. This else if executes some statement depending on some condition. First, check this condition. If this condition is true, then execute this statement. And if this condition is false, then execute this statement. And here I'm gonna write percent getter equal to 45, and inside the curly braces I'm going to write cout second division. And then end line. If this condition is true, then execute this statement. If this condition is false, then it check the next condition. So I'm going to write here else if, and here I'm going to write percent getter equal to 30, and inside the curly braces I'm going to write cout third division. If this condition is true, then execute this statement, else it execute this statement. So what happened here? First, it check this condition. If it is true, then execute this statement. If this condition is false, then it check this condition. If this condition is true, then execute this statement. But if this condition is false, means first two condition is false, then it check the third condition. If this condition is true, then it print this statement. If this condition is also false, means first three conditions are false, then it execute else block. Let's check the output, build and run. As you can see here, it asking for a number. I am going to enter 75. And it print first division, because 75 is greater than 60. So this condition is true, and then it execute this statement. That's why it print first division. Let's check it again. Build and run. I am going to enter 50 and it print second division. Because here first it check this condition and it is false. Then it check this condition. Percent greater equal to 45. Yes, 50 is greater than 45. This condition is true. And then it execute this statement. That's why it print second division. Let's check it again. Build and run. This time I am going to enter 39. And it print third division. First it check this condition. This condition is false. Then it check this condition. This condition is also false. Then it check this condition. 39 is greater than 30. So this condition is true. Then it execute this statement. That's why it print third division. Let's check it again. Build and run. This time I am going to enter 20. And it print fail. Because here all the three conditions are false, so it execute else block and print fail. Next I am gonna teach you nested if. When we write an if else statement inside another if else statement, then it is called nested if. For example, here we write an if statement. Now inside this statement I am going to write another if statement. If pair of parentheses, then pair of curly braces, and now I am going to write else. Inside this if statement you can write another if statement. There is no limit on how deeply the ifs and else can be nested. Similarly, we can write the if statement inside the else block also. So you can write here if a pair of parentheses, a pair of curly braces, and then write else, and then a pair of curly braces. That's it. Hope you understand. If you have any doubt, please comment on the video. See you in next tutorial. Thank you for watching this video. To watch more videos, please subscribe this channel Slide Hunt. You can like my Facebook page at www.facebook.com/slidehunt, and you can follow me on Google Plus at www.google.com/plus/slidehunt.